message and bridge message. Okay? And mainly, we will discuss about different names, names of different parts. Okay? So our main discussion about the and first we are going to discuss about proof process. And then we will discuss about brief process. Mainly we will discuss about the name of different parts and their use. Okay? First is a very important part, this one, this plate, right? On which we are going to connect different members. Okay? The name of that plate is gusset plate. Okay? So we use the same word for the roof truss or for the bridge truss. Okay? So these small plates, right, which are used to connect the member. Can you see? This member is going to finish over here, right? This is going to finish over here. This is going to finish over here, over here. But all these are connected on this plate. Okay? So this is known as gusset plate. It is written over here. G-U-S-S-E-T, right? So what is gusset plate? This is the plate in trusses which is used to make the joint such that all the members are going to meet at one point. Can you see what is where is center line of this one? Here, right?
Yeah.
This center line is here, right? This center line is here. All are going to meet at
one point.
Okay. So our first application which we studied is gusset plate. Okay. So it is common in both ones. Now next is about the roof truss. Okay. Now in roof trusses, this figure, right? This is an example of a roof truss. Okay. Easy to see, is it?
Mm.
Basically, this is your truss. And in this truss, your truss is here. In this one, truss is here, right? This is your truss, is it?
Yes.
This one. In this truss, what are these plates?
Gusset.
Can you see? These are the gusset plates. Same
yes.
is written over here. Gusset plate, gusset plate, gusset plate.
Yes.
Then, this member, which is at the bottom, right? Mind it, this is not the part of the truss, okay? Basically, this is our truss.
Oh.
In this truss, this bottom is known as, all the members which are at bottom, these are known as bottom cock.
Hmm.
Okay? The members which are at the bottom, can you see it is written over here, bottom cock. So basically in a truss, so there is this part, right? This type of truss, right? So it is like this one. So this bottom one is this one, right? What is the name of this? All these
bottom card.
Okay.
Yeah.
So first component is bottom card. Okay. Similarly, this one inclined, this part and this part. Okay. These are known as top card. Can you see this one and this one? These are known as
top
card. Okay. The second name is top card. Usually, when the truss, it is subjected to gravity loads, right? When the truss is subjected to
gravity
load, it means you are applying load over here, here, and here, right? So in your bottom card, there will be tension. In top card, there will be
compression.
Okay. So usually, for the gravity loads, In the bottom card there will be
tension.
In the top card there will be
compression.
Okay, and gusset plates are at the joint. Then next one is this distance from here to here, right? This is known as span. And you see it is written over here. The total length of the truss, okay, from this joint, its center of this joint to the center of this joint. Can you see?
Mm-hmm.
It is known as span. Okay. So after top card, bottom card, next point is
span.
Next is base spacing. What is base spacing? If we want to make make this roof from the truss, right? What we will do? We will place one truss over here, then we will place next truss. Okay. So these are these lines. Can you understand?
Mm-hmm.
These lines are the trusses. Okay.
Yes.
So we will place trusses in one direction. Okay, side by side. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So the distance from one truss to the next truss, it is known as base spacing. Can you see? This is one truss. Okay. Other truss will be over here, right?
Yes.
So the distance from the one truss to the next truss, it is known as the
base spacing.
Agreed?
Yeah, agreed.
So the distance from one truss to the next truss is known as base spacing. Next, now how to apply the loads? To apply the loads only on the joints. Okay?
Yes.
So in the trusses, where loads are applied? Not on the members, right? It is applied directly on the
joint.
So what we do on these points, right? Over here, we place this type of channel sections. We place these members over here along the length. Can you see this C member, right? This one, right? It is placed from one truss to the next truss. Okay. Then this C, right? Can you see this C section? It is placed from this truss to the next truss and so on, right? On the top, we are placing two C side by side, is it?
Yes.
So this is in this direction, this one is in this side, okay? And here is this one, here is this one, right? So
why
these are known as purlins. Yes.
The roof, why are you using C in that I section? Does it
usually for the purlins, we use the channel sections, okay? Because it is easy to connect it on the top and bottom.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay? Sometimes we use C sections over here, sometimes we use Z sections over here. Okay, two sections we use over here, right? Okay, anyways, so these members, if we place from one truss to the other truss, right? So these are known as purlins. Here it is written. Can you understand?
Yes.
The next name is purlins. Okay. The next important terms which we use in the
roof
trusses, right? It is
purlins.
Okay. Then next one is the roof sheet. Okay, so roof sheet is this one. This sheet, right? This one. Okay. So from it is placed on which thing?
On
this
the
roof sheet.
On
it is connected with purlins. Can you see?
Yes.
So we will insert nails over here. Right, Miss Mark.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So such type of thing we call it as to fix it, right?
Yes.
You know we use screws, right? And those are known as self screws to connect it. Okay?
Yeah.
So we will just put it on the end of a machine. Okay? We just put it like this one, it will be drilled.
Mm.
Okay? So these are known as self screws. Okay? But, anyways, so we will fix this sheet on the purlins. Okay? So this is known as roof sheet. Okay? This is known as next important word which we use in the design. In the offices, it is roof sheet. So basically, what will happen? Your load, it will be applied on the
roof
sheet, is it?
Yes.
From roof sheet, it will be applied to the
purlins.
And from purlin to the
joints.
Yes. Okay. Is there is any load in this member or this member?
No.
Right. So basically, purlins helps us to transfer the load from the roof to the
joints
directly. Okay. Okay, I think these are the only things. Top card, bottom card, gusset plate, this is roof or roof sheet. Okay. Then, I am telling you this knee bracing, base bracing, span, purlins. Okay, now here is a little knee brace. Okay. So, brace is like a sport. Okay.
Hmm.
Next one is, it is known as knee brace. Basically, can you see what is depth of this truss over here? It is almost zero, is it?
Yes.
Okay. So to make this trust more stable and to reduce its span. Okay, so what we do, we put these braces over here. Okay. These braces are, you know the braces, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Like, yes, like some people, they place the braces on their teeth, right?
Mm-hmm.
What is the objective? To support the teeth, to make their arrangement a little bit thin,
mm-hmm.
is it? Okay, so same is over here. Their function is to support this length, is
to
it?
Reduce the span.
And it will also help us to reduce the span. And also it will strengthen this end part,
mm-hmm.
is it? If this is absent, right, then what will be position of this one very small depth over here, right? So now we are going to place it, and this brace, it is in compression.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay? So this brace and this one, so we called it as knee brace, okay? And this is quite common in case of trusses, okay? This is known as knee brace, clear? And there are further so many terms which we use. These are the only basic terms, right? For example, from one truss to the other truss, right? So this purlin, right? To make it strong, okay? So we connect this purlin with the next purlin, this purlin with the next purlin, and then it continues on the other side. Can you understand?
Yes.
We place this type of rods, okay, almost this size, and we will connect it from this one to this one, then next one from here to here, next one from here to here, and so on.
Mm.
Okay. These are known as sag rods. Okay. So we place the rods over here, right?
Only one.
This one over here. This is over here, right? Then other one is over here and from here to. So these are known as sag rods. Inside, because now this purlin, it is supported on this truss and on the next truss, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this length is quite long. To reduce its length, right? What we do, we put these type of rods. These are known as sag rods, okay?
Will be in tension.
Yes. So we make, actually when we are in the design offices, we make the design of sheets. So what should be the thickness of sheet? How much would be the overall depth of the sheet? Because usually this sheet is not a plain sheet, right? Okay, so if you see on this end, its sheet will be like this way. Is it?
Yes.
So it has corrugation.
Mm.
So this sheet is known as?
Sheet.
This is roof sheet, right?
Yes.
So this is known as corrugated sheet. CORROGATED. Do you know what is meaning of corrugation?
Yes.
This wavy sheet. Wavy sheet, right? So this is known as corrugated sheet, okay? So what is the advantage of making corrugations?
Water drainage.
Why we are not making it plain? Why we are making it?
Increase height.
Exact. So this will help us to increase its movement of inertia.
Hmm.
Okay? So if your sheet is... I found the sheet. If your sheet is like this way, right? So if you place it like this one, it's easy to bend, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now you make corrugation on it, right? I am making it quickly, maybe it's not a very perfect shape, but anyway, it's good to have the idea, right? Now the sheet is like this one, right? Okay. Now it's not bending, right? Even you put the load, it has some strength, is it?
Yes. Yes.
Can you understand?
Yes.
Mm.
So we are placing this sheet over here. Now it will take some more load, is it?
Yes.
Initially when it was plain, right? So what was happening? You just put it over here, even from the separate it will bend. Okay? So based on these corrugations, right?
We'll take more load.
So its thickness is increased, so its movement of inertia will be increased. So it will help us not to bend. Okay, so this is known as corrugated sheet, right? Corrugated sheet, sag rod. Okay, so we make the design of corrugated sheet. What should be its thickness and overall depth, right? We also make how much length should be there. We also design the screws. How much screws we have to put over there? Okay, so screws is not just only like a screw. We make it waterproof.
Mm.
okay? And also we design these purlins. What should be the depth of these purlins? What should be width of this C-section, this C-section? What should be thickness of this plate? Okay? We also design these all members. How many bolts are required on arch joint? So all these things we design it from A to Z when we want to design a truss, roof truss. Okay, and it is very interesting. Okay, yes.
For the waterproof, is it the same of the water stop?
No, for the to make it waterproof from the top, we use the washers. Okay, rubber washers.
Yes,
okay?
Yes.
So we first put a small piece of rubber. Okay, then on that one the steel washer, and then we put our screws.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
No.
These are not, screws are not put with the epoxy, they are put with the drilling action. Okay, so they are drilled in it, inside, okay? Okay, anyways, then, basically this part is very interesting, right? Especially, there are two stages, rather I will say three stages for this type of, one is the design, right? Which we are doing in the office, right? We are just sitting and we are designing it. How, for example, 1, 2, and 3 are enough. We can make 1, 2, 3, and 4 parts. What will be this depth? So what will be their thickness? How many bolts? So this is one step, right? So this is known as design. Then second is in the factory. Okay. So over there they cut it. This basically this truss. It is made as it is in the factory. And on the side, we just place it. Okay? Over there, they make this type of truss based on the design. Okay? Then they make the purlins, they cut the sheets, they make the knee bracing, all these things. This is known as fabrication. This is known as, first is design, other is fabrication. What will be third one? Third is installation on the side. This is known as erection. So these three stages for the steel structure, design,
fabrication
and erection. Okay. So the most difficult part is erection, right? So the most difficult part is erection. Maybe I can share one of my experience with you. We designed a truss, right? And it was not exactly like a truss, it was more towards the frame element, right? So its span was quite large. Can you understand?
Yes.
So this distance was quite large.
Mm.
So when we designed it, everything was perfect. Okay. Then its fabrication was done properly. Okay.
Mm.
After it, from the side, we get the complaint, right? That when we lift the truss to put it on the top, it bends. So when we lift it over here, so it do not go straight like this, or it bends like this. Can you understand?
Yes.
Yes.
So it should go like this one, right? But when you put it from here, then it bends it like this. Because these are very small members, right? Okay. But when we place it over here, we will have this port, this port, this port, this one, this one, this one, right? But when we are lifting it, these things are absent. Can you understand?
Yes.
Yeah.
So this was another like a challenge. So how to lift it? So we were have the limited cranes also, right? But anyways, then we visited the site and we adjusted it. So the point is, what I want to convey you is that there is, each part is separate, right? And when we are designing it, right? So we need to consider all those aspects. Now at this stage, what you need to learn is just the names. Can you understand?
Yes.
So you need to understand, if I ask you the bottom card, then you must know what is bottom card, top card, purlin, roof sheet, okay? You have the idea, right?
Yes, sir.
Knee bracing, right? Okay? Then the corrugated sheet, right? Sag rod, okay? Self-screws. You must know all these stuff, clear? And you know what will be the load path for the roof sheet. Okay, now the next one is the load path for the load path for the roof sheets, okay? So mean first load will be applied on which part? Load part for
roof.
The roof shear. So first load is applied on
roof.
For the roof trusses. So first load is applied on
the top core joint.
Load is applied on
roof shear.
Yes, is applied on roof sheet. First load will be either it is live load or whatever it is, right? So it is applied on our wind load or snow load, right? Whatever it is, first it will be applied on roof sheet, then roof sheet to
purlins.
Yes, roof sheet to purlins, right? Then what will be next one?
To the joints, from purlins to
it is applied to the truss joint, okay?
Yes.
Then purlins to truss joint. And last one is from the joints to
foundation
end supports. Okay. Then load is applied from the joints to the end support. Okay. So is it possible that I can place one purlin over here?
No. Transfer the load for the moment.
Is it possible that I place a purlin over here?
No,
right? Because if I place purlin over here, what it means?
Step.
It will take the load from the roof and apply it on this member. And it's not required, okay?
Hmm.
So our purlins, they are only connected at the joint, okay? Right? Okay. Then, other than that, we have some small parts. Right, they are known as usually the trims and caps. Trims and caps, okay. So over here on the top, this sheet is going like this way. This sheet is coming like this way, right? What will happen on the top? There will be a joint opening, is it?
Yeah.
Can you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
So this sheet, right, it is going like this way. This sheet is going like this one, right? So what will happen at the top? There will be like opening inside, right?
Yeah.
So over here we will put a cap, right? And it is known as right. Can you understand?
Hmm.
So this will be placed so that water will not come from the top over here. Then also on the edges, right? So what will happen? So roof from the roof sheet, right? Water will go down, is it?
Hmm.
Yes.
Okay. So what will happen during the rain? Water will come everywhere over here.
Hmm.
So what we do? We place a horizontal channel over here. Okay.
Yeah.
We put
to
it
collect
like
the
this.
Water.
We put it like this one. Okay.
This
one. Okay. And also we put it over here like this. Okay. Right. So this is known as gutter.
Okay.
Right. So very bad name, right? So these are known as to collect the water, right?
Yes.
And then, so after some distance, we collect these one in the pipes and it goes down, right? Okay. Then similarly, we have different small shapes. For example, if we want to cover this side, we will cover it like this type of sheet, is it? Can you understand?
Yes.
So that we want to make it a little bit beautiful from this side. We place a sheet over here, okay? Properly designed sheet, right?
Yes.
So this is known as trim. Okay, so different types of trims we use. Clear?
Yes.
So why I am telling you these things? Just to make you know that these are not the only parts, okay? In the concrete structure, it is beam, column, slab, finish, is it?
Mm-hmm.
But in case of steel structure, there are a lot of parts, okay? And we design and we take care of each part separately. Agreed? So you will have these main parts, bottom part, top part, span, base facing, purlin, roof sheet, knee bracing. Other than that, the small part will be like different types of trains, gutters, the top cap over there, sag rod, there are so many other things. Okay, with this our discussion about the roof trusses is over. In the previous class, I showed you different types of the roof trusses, is it?
Yes.
We have the, what was the name, can you recall? We have the K truss, we have the prod truss, we have food truss, right?
Hmm.
Different name based on their shape, right? And in this class, we discuss about different components of the
truss.
Okay, so if you want, I can give you these two or three pages from your this one. Okay, so if you see over here on the first page, these are the types of roof trusses.
Yes.
Then on the second part, this figure in which there are different parts. Okay?
Okay.
Then these are the two parts. Next, we are going to study the part of bridge trusses.
Yes.
Okay? And then we will have the fourth page. It will be the
type of bridge.
The type of bridge trusses.
Yes.
Okay. So now we are going to start our discussion about types of
bridge
trusses. Again, the problem in the bridge trusses is we need to transfer the loads on the joints only. Is it?
Yes.
So, if you want to share it with one another, you can take.
Is this one a truss?
A sort of truss. But actually, this is just a design on the entrance.
So,
okay.
Okay.
So. Okay. So next is now we are going to study the different parts of bridge truss. So first we studied about the
roof truss.
Now we are studying about the bridge truss. Okay.
Doctor, we have 2 minutes to go.
2 minutes to
one
go. Okay. Minute. We need to finish it in 2 minutes. Okay?
1 minute.
Okay, no, 2 minutes. Okay. Okay, let me finish it.
59. Second.
Okay, so next is, it's interesting, right? And hopefully, if you understand the roof truss in its continuation, the bridge truss will be easy to discuss. Okay, here is a bridge truss. Okay. Now, in bridge truss, the interesting thing is, again we need to apply the loads on the
joints.
On the joints, okay?
Yeah.
By the way, where the car will move first, can you guess?
Inside.
Inside.
Over here?
Under the cluster,
down. Also over here, right? Can you see this surface, right?
Yes.
This surface, right?
Yes.
So it will move over here, right? Okay, these are its ports. Now can you see this is one truss? Is it? This is one truss, right?
Yeah.
So basically, the bridge truss, it is made up of
two.
A truss bridge, it is made up of two trusses.
Yes.
Okay. So one will be on this side,
one
this one, right? Other is over here, is it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Then, now in this bridge truss, for example, over here, vertical one board. Okay. So now in this bridge, right, this is one truss over here, other is over here, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Now how to apply or how to make an arrangement so that our load is applied on the joints only? Okay. So what we do, from this truss and another truss, we make these horizontal, these members perpendicular from one truss to the other truss.
Mm-hmm.
Can you see these ones? From
yes.
one joint to the other joint.
Yes.
Yes.
From one joint to the other joint. From this joint to this joint. From this joint, from this joint.
As the base spacing.
No, no, base spacing is different,
floor.
Right?
Floor
so
beam.
We are making these
floor beam.
Beams, right? These beams, right, from one joint to the other, means from, so this joint will be connected with this one, right?
Yes.
Okay, this will be connected over here, 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 and here.
Like
right.
A pure line.
Sorry?
Pure line.
Like?
Pure line, the same for the roof.
Berlin.
Yeah.
Some sort of thing. And over here we call as, this one, floor beams.
Yeah.
We call it as?
Floor beam.
Floor beam. So basically our joint from one truss to the other, they are connected by
floor beam.
Is it?
Yes.
So over here it means we will have a floor beam. Here we will have a floor beam. And over the floor beam,
stringers.
We place these long members, right?
Yes.
And these are known as stringers. These are known as
stringers.
And over the stringers, we put our flooring.
Yeah.
That is known as
deck.
Okay. Then over here, we will place our
deck.
So what will happen? Now the load will be applied on the deck, from the deck to stringer, from stringer to floor beam, from floor beam to the joint, and from joint to the support. Can you see over, where is deck? Can you see?
Yes.
This is deck, is it?
Mm-hmm.
So this deck is supported on the
stringer,
right?
Yes.
Can you see the stringer is written over here? This one, right?
Yes.
These are the stringers. And then load is applied from the stringer to the
floor
beam. This floor beam, and because these stringers, right, they are resting on the floor beam. Okay. Then from floor beam, it will be transferred to the
joint.
This
bottom card.
Bottom card is this one. Top card is this one. This is bottom card for this truss, right? This is top card. Easy, right?
Yes.
Okay, so then there are some more terms, right? One is known as deck. What is deck?
Sorry.
The portion on which the car will move, right?
Surface.
Okay, that surface is known as deck. Under the deck, what will be there?
Stringers.
Stringers, right? And under the stringers, there will be
floor beam.
Perpendicular members, floor beams. And floor beam will be connected to
joints.
So deck. Then over deck there is stringer, then there is the floor beams, and then from floor beams it will be to the joint. Okay, the distance from this one floor beam to the next floor beam, distance from one floor beam to the next floor beam, that is known as panel. Okay, distance from one floor beam to the other one, right? This is known as panel. Okay, so it is known as panel. Agreed?
Agreed.
Okay, then after it, so deck, bottom card, panel, floor beams, everything easy, right?
Yes.
Then stringers. Okay, now, there is, all others are bracings, okay?
Mm.
The bracing on the ends, bracing at the top, okay, inshallah, I will discuss it in the next class, okay?
Yes.
But now the load path is easy, right?
Yes.
So load is applied on deck, deck to stringers, stringer to floor beam, floor beam to the joint, and joint to the support of the truss, okay? Okay, anyways. That's it. So in this class, there are a lot more information than just 2 plus 2 equals to 4, is it?
Yes.
Okay, that's it.
Doctor, for the deck, is it made of concrete?
Okay, how we make the deck, you know, after placing the stringers, we place some like a foam wall, right?
Yes.
And on that we place a layer of concrete, and on that one we place that asphalt layer.
Yes.
You know asphalt, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Asphalt,
okay.
Yeah.
Black top layer, okay?
Yes.
It's fabricated in the industry.
Yes, we make this type of truss, right?
It's very huge.
The problem is, just a minute. Let me answer this question, and then we are going to finish. This question is: do we prepare this type of old truss in the factory? Actually, we prepare it in parts, right? Right. For example, we make this one, this part of exact length, and we also put the holes, okay, in the factory. Then we bring it on the side, and on the side we just erect it.
And weld it.
In the trusses, we do not go for the welding option. Either we use the bolts, or we use the rivets. You know rivet?
Yes,
no.
Yes. It's like this one.
No, not this one. These are the, okay, I will show you a movie, small movie about the rivets. Okay, inshallah, I will make a contest in the next class. Okay.
Thank you.